Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Olympiad. As hopefully you are will be fine. Today we are going to solve a very nice algebraic equation which is given as t minus 1 over t plus 1 is equal to 1. We have to find our roots of t, and in this question we will also explain the extraneous roots. What are extraneous roots? So to solve this, we will solve this by two methods. In method 1, we will rationalize the given statement. So start first method by rationalizing. As you know, in the rationalization we multiply and divide the new denominator term by changing the sign. So in the denominator we have t plus 1. For rationalization we will multiply t minus 1 and also divide by t minus 1 is equal to 1. Now these two after multiplication will become square t minus 1 whole square, and this is the famous formula which is given as a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So according to this formula, the denominator terms will become t square minus 1 is equal to 1, and in the numerator the formula appears is t minus 1 whole square, which is given as a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So using this formula in the numerator term we will get t square minus 2t into 1 plus 1 square over t square minus 1, which is equal to 1. Now multiplying this t square minus 1 with this 1 by cross multiplication method we will get, and simplifying this as well, t square minus 2t plus 1 is equal to, multiplying this we will get here t square minus 1. Okay, now to simplify this we can see that on the both left hand and right hand side there is one term similar which is t square and t square. Both these t squares will be cancelled out with each other and we will get minus 2t plus 1 is equal to minus 1. Now solving this, taking this one towards the right hand side, we will get minus 2t is equal to minus 1 into minus 1, so minus 1 minus 1, and we will get minus 2 is equal to minus 2. Now dividing both sides by minus 2 we will get t is equal to minus 2 over minus 2. These two will be cancelled out and we will get the final answer, the final value of t, which is equal to 1. Now from this is the final answer, and we will check the validity of this answer. For this we will put this value in our given equation. Now the given equation is, so this is the given equation. Now we will check the validity of this root, which is t is equal to 1. So put t is equal to 1 in above equation, we will get 1 minus 1 over 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 over 2 is equal to 1, and 0 over 2 is 0 is equal to 1, which is not possible. Hence this root t is equal to 1 does not satisfy the given equation. Furthermore, as in the start we multiply and divide by t minus 1, from this we can also see it that t cannot be equal to 1. So from this t cannot be equal to 1, it is also proved that t is equal to 1 is the not satisfied solution, and we also verified it from here. So this solution is not satisfied given equation, and hence we can call it as extraneous root. Extraneous roots. From here we can explain the extraneous root as the roots which does not satisfy the given equation. We call them as extraneous roots, and when extraneous root appears it means that no solution exists. In the form of extraneous roots, the solution of the given equation will not exist. So this is the first method. Now in method 2 we will again solve this and find the root as well. For method 2, the given equation is t minus 1 over t plus 1 is equal to 1. Now we will solve it directly by cross multiplication, that is multiplying this t plus 1 here with this 1, and we will get t plus 1 here. So this t will be cancelled out with this t, and we will get minus 1 is equal to 1, which is not possible. So from this it also shows that no solution exists. So from these two methods we prove that the solution of this given equation does not exist and it has extraneous roots. So thank you so much for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos. Thank you.